the Shinko 244. Is it the best dual sport tyre in the budget range? I always thought Shinko was a Chinese brand, but it isn't. Shinko is actually a Korean company making tyres since 1946. And in 1998, they bought the rights to Yokohama motorbike tyres, so they are actually a Japanese-designed tyre, now made in Korea. A riding buddy of mine has used them for years.
When the 690 is not in motard mode, I run a Golden Boy. This tyre has lasted quite a long time, thousands of kilometres. For the price, this is an incredible value for money tyre. They are a cheap tyre, but a good tyre. The Golden Boy is advertised as a 50-50 tyre, 50 dirt, 50 road. But to my mind, it's actually more of a dirt, 70-30. But that doesn't mean it doesn't work good on the road. It actually works brilliantly on the road. And this rounded pattern here is actually what makes it grip really good on the bitumen. The old tyre has gone a bit flat with use, as all tyres do, but it still works really well. The grip's amazing all the time on this tyre.
I have had a few ride on Pete's 690 in the dirt, and yes, the traction is surprisingly good. On many tracks, the grip is almost the same as a full knobby, although you can tell the difference once you hit soft sand or mud. They still do a decent job, but it's not quite the same as a proper knobby. Also, once I saw Pete's tyres, I realised I used to run these tyres on my XR400 20 years ago. Our group did a mix of dirt riding, but also chasing road bikes around the twisties in our local mountain ranges. And knobbies slid around too much and wore out too fast on the road. Most of us started using the Shinkos because they're incredibly cheap, long-lasting, and did a good job on and off-road. Our little riding group was definitely impressed with the 244 as a true 50-50 dual sport tyre. Regular viewers will know I don't normally review tyres, as it's such an individual opinion about what makes a good tyre. So here are some other opinions I found on various forums. The Shinko 244 consistently gets good reviews. So while I don't know if it's the best 50-50 tyre in the budget range, it would certainly have to be up there. Mind you, there are problems reported as well. A few guys report a lot of tyre noise when road riding. However, others say this disappears once you pump them up to the recommended maximum for road use, 28 psi. Pete and I both did this, and yes, they were quiet on the road. A few riders said they found the tyres did start to chunk if run over 75 miles per hour on hub tarmac for extended periods. But obviously, you should aim for a more road-oriented tyre in that case. Pete and I have never encountered tyre chunking with the sort of riding we do, and we do tend to flog the tyres a bit. I never did any road riding in the wet, but while some riders reported the Shinkos were fine in the rain, one rider did comment that the grip was poor on wet roads. A few of my riding buddies are getting into adventure riding. I'm advising them to get the Shinko 244s, and I'll eventually post a long-term review based on their experiences. And if any of you guys use them, let me know what you think in the comments.